Happy Monday, everybody, and welcome to Undisputed Live from Los Angeles. I'm Jen Hale, here with Skip Bayless, Shannon Sharp. Good morning, guys. Did anything
How you doing today, Skip? Skip, how you doing?
What's so funny?
How you doing, Skip?
You all fired up about the Nets?
Yeah, you know what's going to happen. Oh. You know what's about to happen in about 24 hours, don't you, Skip?
I don't know.
You do know.
Help me out.
Okay.
Help me out.
Okay.
Yeah, help me
out. We're about to have a 2, a 6, and a 23.
Really?
Oh, yeah!
Well, he'll always be 2.
Don't do that, Skip. Skip, don't do that. Mm-hmm. Now, he the man to change teams. Yeah, he apologized. Yeah. So let's let it go. We're going to let bygones be bygones.
Not me. Here we go.
We have a ton to get to with free agency today, but let's start with the biggest move of the day yesterday. After months of rumors, Kevin Durant, Kyrie Irving both headed to Brooklyn. Woj reports KD will sign a 4-year, $164 million deal, while Kyrie will sign for 4 years and $141 million. Both contracts less than the max. That way, the Nets can also sign DeAndre Jordan. Durant had interest in the Knicks. However, James Dolan reportedly not prepared to sign him to a max deal because of that Achilles injury. KD is expected to miss all of next season. So, Shannon, how surprised are you that both KD and Kyrie decided to go to Brooklyn?
I'm not surprised at all. Skip, this was, for the most part, most people thought KD was going to leave. And then somewhere shortly before the All-Star game or during the All-Star game, we started hearing the rumblings that KD and Kyrie were going to be a package deal. Mm. Now, they couldn't settle on the team. A lot of people thought it was Brooklyn. Some thought it was the Knicks. Come to find out, KD kind of wanted to go to the Knicks. Kyrie wanted to go to Brooklyn. They ended up going together to the Brooklyn Nets. Mm. But I'm not surprised at all, Skip. And I said this before. I thought the Nets had the better of the two rosters. They have everything better other than the building. Because when you talk about the Knicks, you talk about Madison Square Garden. Ali Frazier fought there, and Billy Joel sold it out, and Jay-Z showed. Oh, you get all this.
Rolling Stone.
Rolling Stone, okay. Rolling Stone sold it out. Mm-hmm. But when it comes down to basketball, because at the end of the day, it doesn't matter where you play. It'll matter the brand of basketball and the organization setup. The Nets have everything that's better. They're better run, better coach. I don't know. I think David Fizdale is a better coach.
I think so. Go ahead.
But I will say this. I just felt the Nets had the better of the pieces. And, Skip, I've said this before. The 30th was the day that, you know, people started, like, you started hearing stuff creep out, and then the first, actually, the day where you guys can sign. But these deals have been in the works for months. These agents have been talking to these teams. Skip, nobody's doing a 5-year, $180 million deal in an hour. These guys have already had, and when guys opt out of contracts for $25, $30 million, they know they got something lined up. Their agents have assured them, we got Team A that's willing to give you multiple year deals at basically that same money. Harrison Barnes opting out of $25 million, Skip? Yeah, when you got 4 years, 88 coming down the line. Al Horford. There's a reason why Big Al opted out of that. Because he knew, his agent had informed him, we got something better. Okay. But Skip, I'm not surprised in any stretch, because what we started hearing is that KD and Kyrie are very close. They might be as close as any other two players in the league, though they never played together. But what we're starting to see, Skip, if you want to get a guy to play with you, go to the Olympics. Because where was that Miami Heat thing fostered? Mm-hmm. LeBron, D-Wade, Bosh at the 08 Olympics.
Right.
Where was this fostered? At the Rio Olympics. So I am not surprised whatsoever. I don't know how true it is, but everybody says that the Knicks would not give KD, because nobody saw his medicals. Basically, you buy it, Skip, I got a car for sale, I ain't let you see it, you buy it as is. It might have an engine, it might not. Might have a back seat, it might not. Do you want it? And I'm charging you an absorbent amount of money. It says James Dolan didn't feel comfortable. But Skip, I can understand that. Mm-hmm. Because normally an injury of this magnitude, it normally takes like 2 years after the injury. So he's not going to possibly play till he's 32, and it might not be until he's 33 that we see the KD that we last saw. But I'm not surprised by this. This had been in the works for at least 3 to 4 months, and it came to fruition. I think the big
for just friendship. Kevin Durant just made a huge mistake to me. And I don't understand it because, in the end, if you told me a month ago that Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving would wind up signing with the Nets, I would have said, yeah, and pigs are going to fly. Because if I told you that a month ago, before we heard any of this, you would have laughed at
yes.
it. It's impossible what just happened. And I'm going to remind everybody, this is for our younger viewers out there. The legacy move for Kevin Durant was obviously to go to the Knicks. If you're not going to stay with Golden State, which was on the table and you were pushing for that, you thought that would be the obvious move, right? Mm-hmm. But if, barring that, if you're going to choose somewhere else to go, it has to be the Knicks. Because I know the kids out there right now think of the Knicks as this. But just for the record, they are the biggest sleeping giant in all of sports. There's nothing close to those Knicks. You could argue the Cubs used to be the Knicks, mm-hmm. but this is the Knicks. They play in the most hallowed arena in all of sports, and it ain't even close, right? It is the Mecca. It is Madison Square Garden. It is entertainment personified because yeah. of all the superstars in all forms of entertainment who have played the palace that is Madison Square Garden. Right. Everybody wants to go there. Every opponent wants to have his best game at Madison Square Garden. I will give you, they have the worst owner in sports, but that has been slightly canceled by a very good coach in David Fizdale.
Yeah, I like Fizz.
And if you look at Scott Perry's track record, they're fairly new GM. He's been there 2 years. He has a resume behind him. He helped build the Pistons championship team and that run that they had.
Yes.
Okay, so I respect him, and I respect what they could be, and I don't respect the fact that Kevin said no to this. And I get it, and ESPN reported that they wouldn't offer the max to Kevin Durant mm-hmm. because of injury history. I'm going to get to that in just a minute because you did make a strong point. He does have injury history, and he is... He's a pretty big risk yeah. right now, okay? I get that part. But it also came clear later in the evening